You have very clearly described the financial management that we have to take during this pandemic situation. So what can we do for the clinic staffs and associated doctor salary? What is your opinion?
Correct. I think this is the one of the biggest questions, staff salary, correct? Younger dentists, you may have, I think, one assistant and one receptionist if you have, say, two staff members. Mm-hmm. And you really will have a problem paying their salaries. So my suggestion, March salary, because the lockdown, I think, in Bangladesh also started somewhere in the end of March, you have to pay them. Mm-hmm. April salary, I think, on humanitarian grounds, we need to pay them. Mm-hmm. Because they also have to pay rent, they also need to purchase food, you know, they also have a family, so we need to pay them for sure. Mm-hmm. Young dentists, May salary, you can have a talk with them. Mm-hmm. And say, I can pay you 50% salary now, because even I am in trouble. Mm-hmm. You can always show your, you know, they will also come to know that what was your income, you know, approximate income in say March or February, January, December. And suddenly it's zero. They also know that you have a, you know, loan EMI you have to pay. And if you, they don't know, let them know now. It's, I think, time they should know your expenses also. And say 50% of the salary for the month of April. Correct? Sorry, for the month of May, 50% salary. For the month of June, if you really cannot afford, tell them we'll have to pay you 30% of your salary, because it will take care of your, you know, food requirements and a little bit other things. And ask them if there is any other family member who is also earning, because if that family member is earning, I'm sure that person also, if he's earning in a factory or somewhere, would probably also be laid off and have a salary cut, or definitely that will be there. Everybody will have the same issue. But at least in a family of your assistant's family, if there are 5-6 people and two are getting some income, may not be full, but some income. And if their ration, which is food, and their rent has been taken care of, correct? And in these crisis times, even they don't need Amazon, even they don't need to buy mutton and chicken every day. Mm-hmm. They can be vegetarian also for a few more days or months. Mm-hmm. They can have dal rice, like I am having dal rice and a simple vegetable since lockdown. Mm-hmm. So don't worry. From June onwards, if you really cannot afford, because now you are in minus, negative, you don't have takas, and you have to, you are minus 10,000 takas because of your rent and your, you know, other expenses, your family expenses, your parents which are dependent on you or something. Mm-hmm. Then in that case, you tell them, I will be able to send you ration every month. I will send you few kgs of dal, rice, you know, oil, onions, potatoes, tomatoes, you know, a bunch of coriander and a bunch of these, the basic food requirements. I will be able to send it to you. Either you will have to collect it, or if in Bangladesh there is home delivery service like in India, mm-hmm. through local shopkeepers or something in this lockdown, yeah. See that the material reaches your assistant's house. That way you can continue, because a simple maths I did, if you happen to pay them, say their salary is say 4,000 taka, mm-hmm. and you have to pay them for 4 months or 5 months, mm-hmm. and that will be 20,000 takas, and you can't have that payment, you can't do it. Mm-hmm. And instead you send ration to them for say 3 months out of that, mm-hmm. ration will not cost you, I'm sure, more than 2,000 takas, you know. So 2,000 to 6,000. And instead of, say, now 20,000 takas, you will be just 6,000 takas. And trust me, this is a humanitarian gesture also. Mm-hmm. Sometimes this class of people understand this gesture more than money. You know, if you really, really cannot afford, mm-hmm. please tell them you will have to stay at home. I just cannot pay you. You know, I even can't buy your ration, because even I don't have money. I am also eating just one meal a day. I'm really in a bad shape. Mm-hmm. Okay. If this is your real, real situation, my suggestion, people like Dr. Sattar and dentists who are well settled in life, mm-hmm. we need to talk to them then, you know. I think you can form one small organization quickly. I suggest you to do it, where you ask these very, very extremely needy dentists to get in touch with you. Simultaneously, you get in touch with these dentists who are 55, 60 plus, 50 plus, who, you know, are good enough in their finances. They have no issue even if this lockdown continues for 1 year, or they don't have practice for 1 year, but they can sustain their, they have to reduce their lifestyle, but they can sustain. Ask for their help to help these young dentists, you know. I'm sure, like, I am ready to feed 5 young dentists for the next 1 year if they are really in dire straits, you know. I found a few more dentists of my age group who said and told me, sir, suggest a business plan, you know. So I said, yes, there is a business plan here also. If Atik, you can afford to help some young dentist, what you tell him is, I will pay off your rent for the next 1 year. I will purchase the necessary sterilization equipment and materials required for the clinic. I will modify the interior of your clinic as per the guidelines. Only thing is, you will have to make me a partner in your clinic for, say, 20% of profits from the clinic. Okay? And you have an agreement proper on paper that I am the partner in the clinic, non-working partner, financial partner. 20% or 15% I will be getting from the profit every month. And all what I pay in the form of rent and this purchase of equipment material, which is a capital expense, the dentist can return you slowly over a period of 3 years, and it can be interest-free because you're already taking. So example, if you watch a program called Shark Tank on television, you know, it's the program for these angel of the angel investors and people, how they invest in big businesses or in ideas of small people. Yes, behave like a shark here. But this shark, see that you are on humanitarian grounds. This shark, after a year, you have a choice of continuing with that young dentist as his business partner, you know, and help him expand. Or you have a choice of retreating from his business and hand over his, you know, papers back to him. Be a gentleman at that time. You don't have to grab his practice, correct? So I guess dentists who can afford, this is an opportunity for you to get into a chain of clinic type of business, you know. And just be on humanitarian levels. Don't do it for greed and money levels. You know, that will bounce back, I'm sure, on you. So I think this could be the answer for these young generation dentists. We need to take care of them.
That is a good idea that you have given.
Yes. So, yes.
Most of the Bangladeshi dentists, they have a tendency like they want to practice till they are dead. And you have said many times that you are going to in a retirement plan, and you have joined in a different company as a non-executive
director.
So I want to know what is your retirement plan, and would you please share with us what is that company you are working, what is the activities of that company?
Okay, so I'll put it this way. To begin with, first of all, this is, I think I entered BDS in 1981, so that's 39 years ago. Correct, my maths is poor. So that's 39 years ago. So 39 years ago, I am in this beautiful profession of dentistry, correct? I never wanted to be a dentist in life, trust me.
Okay.
39 years, I did it with full-on passion. I devoted to the profession. I loved the profession. You know, I made name, I made fame, I made money out of the profession. Everything I did, correct? I realized that my daughters are not into the profession. They are one is an architect and one is a biomedical engineer. I realized then, actually, what am I doing in life? Why am I keeping on expanding? When I started my life in a 140 square feet small clinic, slowly increased from one chair to two chairs to now three chairs in a 1500 square feet clinic, and you know, life is just, I realized, what am I doing? Why am I doing? I actually never wanted to be a dentist, but I've done enough for the profession. in all angles. I've also had run my own dental laboratory for 25 years. My laboratory was famous for porcelain veneers, and every film industry patient in India, the Bollywood of India, everybody's restorations have been created. Almost 80% of them have been created in my lab. The dentist could be different, you know, but the preferred lab was my lab. So I think I have done enough in that line also. I am being a speaker for my association. I have been visiting Bangladesh. I think 7 years I have come in a row to Bangladesh. Mm-hmm. I have my conducting my own courses. I have run the longest running course in India since 2002 now. Mm-hmm. I think I have achieved everything what I wanted to. So I had to take one decision. So 2 years ago, I think, first of all, 8 years ago, I closed down my lab, which was giving me a lot of income, I'm telling you. But I had guts to close it down, because it was the most stressful part of my life. It even gave me a cardiac problem for which I had to undergo surgery in 2007. You may not be knowing this, but I stopped my lab with 21 employees overnight. I closed it on 1st of January, I think 2012. Okay. Then slowly, 2 years ago, when I finished 32 years in clinical practice, I took a decision of closing down from there also. I announced my decision on 1st of January 2 years ago, and I just closed it. I never handed over the keys also to any young dentist. I never thought of selling my practice, nothing. And instead, I gave the keys of my clinic to my daughter and told her, if you wish to start your office here, you can. Mm-hmm. And in the last 2 years, my daughter's company, which I am executive director of, called Telehealth Innovations Foundation. Okay. We have our head office in my clinic now. We have 12 employees working under that company. This is amazing. Most of the world, mm-hmm. we expect our children to join our profession. Here is one man. I am abstract by nature. You all know me by nature so many years. I am a different thinker. I have joined my daughter's profession. But I am as a non-executive director. The reason is, I am still in touch with dentistry because my courses and my lectures across India are still on. I am still traveling 245 days a year to lecture and conduct programs for IDA, FAMDENT, courses everywhere. The only last 2 years I have not come is Bangladesh. But I have come everywhere I am traveling. So I'm a little bit caught in there. But this lockdown has taught me one thing, that I can continue my education now online. Mm-hmm. I need not anymore travel, and I need not anymore conduct real hands-on courses eye to eye. I can have a hands-on course on Zoom where Dr. Atik is sitting in front of me with air rotor and working as per my demonstration and showing me the tooth preparation on Zoom, and paying a very small fee for it instead of paying 30,000 takas for my program. Because if 12 people I teach, I charge 30,000. Mm-hmm. If I teach 1,000 people at a time, I think I can charge 300 takas or even lesser than that, mm-hmm. you know. So that's what I'm thinking, and I'm planning to now join my daughter's company, Telehealth, full-time or at least part-time. That's my retirement plan. I've already retired. But that's what I'm looking for the next 5 years. And of course, pursue my hobby of photography, which was kept under the carpet for several years. And now I suddenly have realized that I can even be a cook. May not be a chef now, but a cook. If worst time comes, Atik will employ me in his house as a cook. And I am ready to cook delicious Bangladeshi food for Atik and his family. And in return, Atik can give me a little salary per month. And Atik can give me 2 meals per day and just 2 sets of clothes. Mm-hmm. Because in this lockdown, I also realized that you don't need clothes. That's the best thing. I have been wearing those 2 things. Amazing. 1, 2 pairs of shorts and 2 pairs of one shirt and 1 t-shirt. For the last 30 days. So there is no need.
This is really amazing.
So amazing. Yeah. Why not?
Very tough, actually, to make a program with you within time limit. As I'm sure our audience can listen you hours after hours with
comfortability.
Yes, yes. But
I love Bangladesh. I love Bangladesh. So I can keep talking to every Bangladeshi dentist for hours.
But we have to bound to wrap up our program. And my last question to you, I want to listen in short. What do you think about future dentistry? I don't want to know about future of dentistry. What is the future dentistry?
You mean post-COVID? Do you mean post-COVID?
I want to know actually future dentistry. Like you are working in an organization, telehealth. Is there any possibility that the...
Oh, yes, of course, of course, of course.
Yeah.
Teledentistry.
Yeah, teledentistry. Correct.
Oh, there is already a lot happening in America and Europe on teledentistry. Mm-hmm. I was watching a live interview of Dr. Christian Coachman, the DSD guy, mm-hmm. whom I have been talking in Bangladesh also. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Coachman conducted an interview with one dentist from, I think, Kylie Stanley, if I'm not mistaken. He is already having a platform of teledentistry, a software. He's own developed his own software on teledentistry and is already doing it for his own clinic. Mm-hmm. My daughter already is working on telemedicine for the last 5 years on a global platform, mm-hmm. you know, in various countries. And your photograph changed, something happened. So somebody else has come in now and is it hacked or something? Atik? I think the program has been hacked or something.
No, sir. I'm online. Okay.
So, whose photograph was that on my screen? Okay. Because Zoom is getting hacked. Be careful.
Okay. No.
Be careful.
Okay.
So where was I? Yes. So teledentistry, yes, could be the next big thing. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure government of Bangladesh and even government of India will make some policy changes and allow teledentistry to happen. And that will make us, you know, have telephonic consultations with the patient even before the patient coming to our clinic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we will save so much time because this normal habit of a patient coming to our clinic and some, you know, that class of patients who asks, kitna taka, how much taka for this filling?
Mm-hmm.
That class can now ask us all these questions on our phone itself to our receptionist. And there only we can filter out this crowd. There is no need to call this patient to the clinic if they can't afford your charges. And on telephone itself, on a teledentistry platform, on a video call, you can refer the patient to a person whom they can afford. You know, a lot of things can happen on teledentistry. Patient education, patient awareness, teleconsultation, teleprescriptions, if you could take a proper medical history of the patient, everything is possible. Everything. So start Googling about teledentistry. I think Kylie Stanley, K-Y-L-E Stanley. Mm-hmm. I'm sure he was the dentist. He's my Facebook friend also.
Mm-hmm.
Read more about teledentistry. And Atik, you be the first one to start it in Bangladesh.
Okay. Thank you for the nice concept. Thank you very much, sir. It was nice to have a resourceful and informative conversation with you. I think my audience have also enjoyed this session. I would love to request if you have any question regarding our today's discussion, feel free to write us in the comment box. And I would like to request Dr. Rajiv Verma to answer those questions in your convenient time. And thank you once again to join with me and take our gratitude from Bangladesh. And last but not the least, I would like to thank my audience who have enjoyed our program with passions, and you are the heart of my program. I wish you a good health and a prosperous life. Thank you for watching me. Stay home, stay safe.
Same here. Thank you, Atik. Thank you, Bangladesh. Love you all. Bye-bye.